Hello guys, welcome to the channel. This is UGREEN SSD Enclosure and there is a 500 gigs of Samsung 980 SSD inside it. And I already made a detailed review video for this one, how fast it is, but in the real world, actually I am using this. And if you are thinking to get one of these, probably you are making some video editing work and you need an SSD enclosure, external SSD, for your workflow. If you have a MacBook Air M1 256 gigabytes of SSD, it's obviously not enough for video editing workflow. If you make some, you know, if you make longer videos like 10 minutes, or maybe someone, or maybe some people makes videos about 30 minutes. But I have a timeline here, which is 4K at 30 FPS and it's recorded with the Insta360 4K lens with the H.265 codec. I think it's also called as HEVC codec, which reduces bigger file sizes, but it's a little bit hard for the computer systems to render. So first today, what I am going to try, I am going to render this one, this 7.7 minutes and 26 seconds timeline with the onboard SSD first for the MacBook Air, and then I am going to render it on this UGREEN SSD enclosure. And you can find all product links that I mentioned in this video in the video description. So let me show you this. Okay, let me open the back. So as you can see, I am going to connect the enclosure directly from the Thunderbolt 4 port here, the black one, because I am charging my computer on Bezos 8-in-1 USB-C docking station. And this is the best USB-C docking station that I have used, because I have purchased several different brands and they all burned up, but this Bezos is working fine. You have the internet connection port, SD, micro SD and SD card ports, HDMI port, charging port. There are three USB 3 ports here. So enough talking, let's get started rendering. First, I am going to start rendering with the onboard computer's 256 gigabytes of SSD. Then we will be trying the UGREEN enclosure. Let's see. Okay. Computer H.264, better quality. I am choosing this to get better result for YouTube uploads. Sorry. 4K 30 FPS, and let's start. Let's prepare our stopwatch. Okay. Next. Test M1 256 gigabytes. Save and start. Okay, it is started. It's been 7 minutes and 50 seconds. The rendering is at 78%. Let's wait and see how long will it take. Okay guys, with the MacBook's 256 gigs of SSD, the stock one has finished rendering at 11 minutes and 21 seconds. Let's say 22 seconds. The timeline is 7 minutes and 26 seconds. The time 11 minutes and 22 seconds. Okay. Now let's copy this exact same project to our UGREEN SSD which I already plugged in and see how fast it's going to finish the rendering process. Copy UGREEN Enclosure. Oh, it's already here, but I am going to delete it and copy it again. Paste. Also, the data transfer is really fast. The total size is 21.08 gigabytes. The file is really big and it took less than 20 seconds, something like that. Okay, it's copied. Now let's close the Final Cut and open it from here. I am still using the trial version. Okay, project is here, 7 minutes and 26 seconds. H.264, 4K, 30 FPS. Next. Let's check UGREEN. Okay, we are going to save it here. Let's say test UGREEN. Save, start, and see the light on the enclosure is flashing. When it's flashing, it means it's in the process, and it's already 3%. Okay, it's been 8 minutes and 40 seconds, and the rendering percent is 82. I think the time is going to be really similar between the onboard SSD and the external SSD enclosure. I know there is too much things going on the onboard SSD, the Mac system and swapping the other apps, but it looks like you don't have to spend hundreds of dollars more to get more storage on your MacBook, because you can just get this combination just around $100, actually a little bit under $100, and this is a very good bargain. Okay, let's see how much time it's going to take exactly, because the onboard SSD time was 11 minutes and 22 seconds. At the moment it's 85%, and we have almost 1 minute and 30 seconds. 10 minutes, 86%. Okay guys, the onboard SSD is faster about 7.5 seconds. This is actually really surprising, this small combination under 100 bucks is giving the same, almost the same performance. And as I mentioned, yes, I know there are a lot of things going on the stock SSD, but instead of, for example, spending $200 more to get 512 gigabytes of onboard SSD, you can get 256 gigabytes. And then you can get the 500 gigabytes of an SSD, external SSD with the enclosure. So you get actually 750 gigabytes of storage without spending $200, and you get more storage. I think this enclosure was priced as $26, and the SSD inside is about $56. I'm going to put the links in the description. You can check from there. But I am really impressed. And if I take in my hand, no, it's not hot at all. Honestly,
This is the first time I tested and I didn't expect this result, especially the those times. They are almost identical. It's awesome.
Okay, everyone, thank you very much. So I just would like to show you how easy to use this tiny enclosure. This is the front side and this is the back side. You just take the SSD and plug it in. That is all. This was a really interesting test even for me because I really didn't test it. I tested with you together and this was very impressive actually. So I am very happy that I didn't pay $200 more for the extra storage on my MacBook Air. Okay guys, as I mentioned, if you would like to get these items, you can find the links in the description. And what is it on my head? It looks really bad. Anyway, as always, thank you for watching. Have a good day.